Hello, everybody. I'm Tim Spector from the Zoe COVID and Health Study. And this week, as cases are dropping some more and some new Omicron variants starting to emerge, I'm going to be sharing the results of our earringing survey, find out just how bad it is for some of you catching COVID, and also be looking at some of the symptoms most commonly reported by people suffering from cancer compared to completely healthy people. And some of these results may actually surprise you. So in addition, I'll be telling you about the launch of a brand new menopause study on the app and details of how you can get involved. And Zoe is conducting the world's largest study into diet and menopause. So this is a great opportunity for you to take part and shape the future of science in some of these areas that have really been understudied in the past. But first, let's take you through some of this week's COVID data. Basic good news is that cases are still decreasing, and this rate of decrease has actually picked up from last week. And we're now down to about 173,000 cases, which is about 24% less than we saw last week. Now, finally, this has got below the January peak. It's obviously taken us a long time to get there, but we are there now, and it's on the way down, particularly as the good weather is improving. This is a really good sign. Not out of the woods yet, though. Still one in 20 people that you might bump into currently have COVID. So definitely not a time to think that you can't get infected if you haven't been so recently. Now, looking at the usual rates for deaths and hospitalizations, there's no real change in death rates attributed fully or in part to COVID. It's around 200 a day. That's still staying probably above where we'd want it to be. Hospitalizations has dropped a little bit and is now below this pretty critical 2,000 a day average, but it will vary from different parts of the country. No real change, though, in those severely ill on ventilators yet. Now, a little word about variants. We talk about the Omicron BA1, the BA2. There's a couple of new ones you need to probably know about, BA4 and BA5. They're other Omicron subtypes. They're not yet at worrying levels. There have been about 1,300 cases of BA4 that have been reported in England and one case in Northern Ireland, but it's a very small proportion of the current levels, which is still mainly BA2. We are keeping an eye on this because South Africa is where Omicron first was picked up, and they are seeing BA4 and 5 increasingly quite fast. So we'll keep you updated. Quickly onto age groups, these continue to fall across all the age groups, and no real change there, no real effect of the Easter holidays yet. And a similar picture where we look at regions, we can see that Scotland, which started to decrease first, is being caught up by all the other regions in the UK, and so not much disparity between them currently. And it's important to realize that the results that we're giving at Zoe are likely reflecting the real results. The numbers of confirmed cases that you get from the government is about 5 or 6 times lower than the real results when you compare the surveys like the Zoe one or the ONS one. And this is because people are no longer resubmitting tests. Government and the NHS doesn't accept lateral flow tests. So you really can't depend on any trends or anything from the government data unless it's survey data. But what we can be aware of is actually what's happening with symptoms. And that's what we do know a lot about. And here's the current top 20, which shouldn't be news to most of you by now. And the good news is that your reports are still coming in and looking really accurate. So thank you for that. 84%, it keeps creeping up now, of new COVID cases presenting with a runny nose, and 67% will be sneezing. And most of that is not just due to hay fever. Now, we asked we did a little survey of whether any of you had suffered from ear ringing, also known as tinnitus, which is something we haven't heard much about. But it turns out that 19%, or nearly one in five of you, did have some ear problems with COVID. And in our newsletter, we got 14,500 of you to complete the survey. And we had about 5,000 of you tested both positive for COVID and had the ear ringing. And what we learned from this was that for a few, it only lasted a couple of days. And most people, that's over 50%, said they were still experiencing some form of ear ringing that probably comes and goes and is mild or moderate for weeks or months afterwards. And this was a bit of a shock to me. I thought it would just something that went. I did get it, but it disappeared pretty quickly in me. Obviously, a lot of people do suffer from tinnitus, and you told us that generally got worse when you got infected. And I think it's a symptom that now is also going along with some of these long COVID symptoms we talked about quite a lot in the past. Now, this highlights the first time the ear ringing, as with long-term loss of smell, we saw particularly the previous variants, is something to take really seriously, because it does suggest that a different part of the body has been affected, more internal, more close to the brain. And we've heard anecdotally from my ENT colleagues that they have seen an increase in referrals with tinnitus following COVID. And it really is something that we need to know more about and see whether people are going to end up with more permanent problems. Hopefully not, but it's a great example of what we can achieve working together. Another area where we work together is on cancer. And we've been tracking symptoms of people who actually currently suffering from cancer. They're either under treatment or recently being diagnosed. And we've got about 7,000 of you who've been logging your symptoms over this time, and compared to a control group of 29,000 who also had cancer, and neither group had COVID. And so we were looking at non-COVID type symptoms. And you can see on this graph here that in general, you see a higher rates in people with cancer than in the control group for people reporting multiple symptoms. And generally people are sicker, as you would expect. Now, the symptoms are interesting. And when we get down to the individual ones, you can see in the next graph here, we get an idea that many of these symptoms are related to the side effects of the drugs. Chemotherapy, for example, has big effects on hair and also on your skin, causing lots of skin rashes, etc. But there seem to be a lot of other complaints in the middle that might be more related to our immune system. The other interesting thing was that altered sense of smell was quite common in cancer patients, just as it is with COVID sufferers. This shows that the daily flow and the app is an important introduction, which we're going to be rolling out soon. And we can look at these more minor symptoms that really haven't had any medical attention in the past, and seeing which of these might be immune related that we hadn't thought about either. And so I think following up loss of smell might be another interesting way to go. Now, every time we show a picture of someone's tongue, I get a lot of comments on my Twitter account. It seems that you guys like that. And this is a picture of a classical geographical tongue that you get with many diseases, infections, autoimmune diseases, drug related, and it is also related to COVID infection as well. And this was commoner in the cancer patients. So I think we're going to be looking more into these minor immune symptoms and also the effect of diet quality to see whether what you're eating can have an effect on these more minor symptoms. A word about our menopause study. We are really, because we've shown these effects of weight on menopause, we're now really interested in how diet impacts menopause, and we're launching the largest study of this kind. And we're going to be sending an email to 90,000 of you who are in various stages of menopause and have consented to the Zoe Health study. So do look out for your email invitation. And just to remind you, last week we showed this link between menopause and weight gain, but also found that those who had an excess weight also experienced more menopausal symptoms. And I'll put a link to the video in the description below. So research like this is particularly important, especially timely now that we seem to have very strange HRT shortages currently in the UK. And it would be good to look at non-pharmaceutical approaches as well, because not everyone gets on with HRT, and we do need to have a holistic approach. But with your contributions to the survey, I think we're going to be doing amazing things, particularly looking at the understudy area of menopause and identify some of these key lifestyle changes that are going to help women's health. So to round up, this is just the start of what our app can do. And another example is the current outbreak of viral hepatitis in children, which is still unclear what's causing it and why it doesn't seem to be affecting adults. But it's an example of how something like our app rolled out to pick up hepatitis in the population could pick this up early and save many problems. And that's another reason we're keeping an eye on. We want to know your symptoms, particularly the variants change, or if we have outbreaks of diarrhea or GI symptoms, they might be indicators of hepatitis, which generally gives yellowing of the skin, of the eyeballs, and tongue. And so really important you do report any symptoms, even if you don't think it's COVID related. We're going to be introducing new features to allow you to report all your health symptoms every day in a much easier way to track all these health conditions. And don't worry, we're still going to be tracking new variants in COVID as well. It was good to see companies like British Airways that emailed me recently directly recommending that on flights, I wear a high quality FFP2 or FFP3 mask rather than any old paper or cloth mask, which are much less likely to protect you. We do know our technology is incredibly valuable, and this will be a crucial tool for health, all health matters. So please do remember to like and subscribe to our channel. It really helps spread the word. Share the app with friends and family, and do keep an eye on our website for details. And finally, thanks again, and support science and keep logging.